So I have a confession to make. Everything smart which has to be said about this topic has already been said by Bhupesh in the morning. And everything impressive which was supposed to be seen was shown in the Malcolm demonstration. So I know I'm not going to make the cut. So I'm going to be very brief. I'm going to show you some pictures and share my perspective. The first perspective before I go into pictures is that, guys, you're sitting in 2018. If you're still talking about building data-driven organizations, we have failed miserably as an industry, as a professionals. Driverless cars and drones, Uber drones, are knocking on our door. Okay, and it's an age of data disruption through data. And if you're still talking about data-driven organization, I'm sorry, we have lost the decade. So with that, I'm going to talk, because still the topic is building data-driven organizations, so we're going to talk about a little bit about that. So first thing, what's the big deal? Data has been available since ancient ages. Every business, I've not heard of any organization who has not used data for any decision making. Whatever, it may be less data, it may be bad data, it may be irrelevant information, but they have always survived and thrived making decision making on data. And they have been doing it very well. You know, we have had three types of organizations, you know, ones who sell products, the others who sell services, and the third time where you are the product. Until decision, and the whole concept of data-driven decision-making is because in the VUCA world, decision-making became more complex. More and more factors became more prevalent, influencing your decision. And obviously, competition started increasing. And these guys arrived, which made more money by simply using your data, which you had ignored. Now, you thought that's a pretty damn good idea. You know, they used that data to make more money with me, and traditionally I'm in an asset heavy and a product driven business. And how do I get that market share? How do I still make more money? So what I want to do, I want to win in the same race, and suddenly I wanted to build a data driven organization because of that jargon. But most of the organizations didn't know where to start. And they were scratching their heads. Because the challenge was very simple. Either there was a problem with their technology in which their data was structured, or there was a problem with the mindset in which people were operating. And they wanted to fix this both. Because the technology stack which they have worked with looked like this. That means they had grown incrementally or with M&As, organically and inorganically, and they kept, you know, adding more and more disparate systems onto their technology stack. And now getting data was very difficult. Plus, the organization structure looks like this. I'll take a moment. Where you had the chief idea killer for anything new, and you had to work through different layers of bureaucracy with, obviously, that director of analysis and paralysis. So what do you do? So what the organizations wanted to do, take a balance. Do they fix their technology stack? Do they get all their, do they build it grounds up? Do they hire IBMs of the world to fix their technology and get data in the right format? Or they fix culture, whether they go after the mindset. They go after that last person who is on the street, on the person who is making the money for them to change his mindset to make more data-driven decision. So before you scratch your head, what is the right thing to do? Let me give you some very simple 7 steps. First of all, hire some change agents. If they come from Aegis, well and good. Okay. Give them some superpowers. Give them the powers to create and act on the changes which you have described, so that they can focus on the solutions and not problems. Not the problems of technology, not the problems of culture. So let's start from the very basic. So building a data-driven organization, this is a 7-step methodology. 7 is the holy number in India. So I stuck with 7. Focus on your data structures. In an age where we struggle to get data on time, forget, you know, investments. People are trying to do investments in data structures. So the first and foremost thing, revisit your data structures, your master data management. Revisit your data integrity plan, your data quality plan, and how you can fetch data and store information. Step 2, invest in your data architecture model grounds up. It's very important. Facebook, Amazon, Apple, they're all, Google, they're all in this race. They're winning this race in the artificial intelligence because they have built their data architecture grounds up and not in existence after 15, 20 years in business, thought about that, yes, we need to take data and, you know, get into a competitive edge. Step three, digital is the only way. There's no doubt about it. If any of your processes, if any of your process architecture is non-digital, please go and revisit it. That's the only way. More importantly, from a mindset and a culture perspective, involve everyone. Together is better, because there will be a lot of naysayers, there will be a lot of fence-sitters, and there will be a lot of, you know, people who will be accelerating. But it's very important to, from a change management perspective, involve everyone in this journey. It might go a little slow, but it will be steady. Step five, have clear measurement outcomes. We shy away from measuring ourselves. Most of the organizations, departments, functions, they do not want to get measured, because they will say it's too subjective, you know, you don't understand our business dynamics, is very different. I do not agree. And I'm sorry, I'm a very opinionated, biased, and a judgmental person. So measure your outcomes. It's very important. Celebrate small little wins. Reward people who are taking these bold steps. It's very important to have that culture shift rather than just a technology shift. And we have heard this word called transformation in multiple companies. Some companies go in multiple frequencies of transformation but never get desired results. That's because they do not focus on the culture. So the culture piece have to be strengthened as well. And more importantly, number seven, repeat this process relentlessly until you receive the outcome you want. So the outcome, what is the outcome? You're making better decisions. You're on a digital highway with lots of information flowing in real time to your desk, to your person who's going to make that decision. And you are doing a new way of working. You are happy, because with this you are set to make more money, and that's how it's done. That would be my brief. I thought I was within 8 minutes, right? Okay. Thank you guys.